Welcome, welcome, welcome.
Back. How wonderful. Stanley was alone.
The Stanley Parable.
Finally. This is great.
We've learned
he thought
that
to himself.
I am not
this
really
is what
Stanley.
I wanted all along. I got what I wanted.
And whoa, whoa. But I think we broke the game before.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
Guess speedrun this.
Yet there was not a single person here either. Feeling a wave of disbelief, Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office,
hoping
Stanley stepped into the broom closet, but there was nothing here, so he turned around and got back on track.
I really can use a tape measure, too.
There was nothing here. No choice to make, no path to follow, just an empty broom closet.
Okay.
No reason to still be here.
We're going downstairs.
Coming to a staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office.
We're going for this, baby.
But Stanley
nice
just
car.
Couldn't do it. He considered the possibility of facing his boss. Admitting he had left his post during work hours,
he
might be fired for that.
And
in such a competitive
fired.
Economy, why had he taken that risk? All because he believed everyone had vanished? His boss would think he was crazy. And then something occurred to Stanley. Maybe, he thought to himself, maybe
second.
I am crazy. All of my co-workers blinking mysteriously out of existence in a single moment
like
for no reason at all. None of it made any
circles.
Logical sense.
We are.
And as Stanley pondered this, he began to make other strange observations.
Yeah.
For example, why couldn't he see his feet when he looked down?
Oh my gosh.
Why did doors close
my
automatically
feet.
Behind him wherever he went?
Doors?
And for that matter, these rooms were starting to look pretty familiar.
I already
were
noticed
simply
that.
Simply repeating. No, Stanley said to himself, this is all too strange. This can't be
dream.
Real. And at last, he
I'm
came
dreaming.
To the conclusion that had been on the tip of his tongue. He
yes.
just hadn't found the words for it. I'm dreaming!
I already said that.
He yelled. This is all a dream.
La, la, la.
Oh, what a relief Stanley felt to have finally found an answer, an explanation. His co-workers weren't actually gone. He wasn't going to lose his job. He wasn't crazy after all.
Do I have
he
to,
thought
like,
to himself, I suppose I'll wake
somehow.
Up soon. I'll have to go back to my boring real-life job pushing buttons. I may
yes.
as well enjoy this while I'm still lucid.
We will enjoy
this. So, he imagined himself flying and began to gently
Yay.
Float above the ground.
I'm flying!
Then he
Whee!
Imagined himself
Ow,
soaring through space on a magical star field, and it
wow.
too appeared. It was so much fun, and Stanley awesome. Marveled that he had still not woken up. How was he remaining so lucid? And then perhaps the strangest question of them all entered Stanley's head. One he was amazed he hadn't asked himself sooner.
Maybe I'm lost.
Why is there a voice in my head dictating everything that I'm doing and thinking?
You're in my head.
Now the voice was describing itself being considered by Stanley, who found it particularly strange. I'm dreaming about a voice describing me, thinking about how it's describing my thoughts, he thought.
Yes.
And while he thought it all very odd and wondered if this voice spoke to all people in their dreams, the truth was that, of course, this was not a dream. How could it be? Was Stanley simply deceiving himself?
Yes.
Believing that if he's asleep, he doesn't have to take responsibility for himself? Stanley is as awake right now as he's ever been in his life.
Oh, no.
Now, hearing
so
the voice speak these words was quite
forever.
A shock to Stanley. After all, he knew for certain, beyond a doubt, that this was, in fact, a dream. Did the
yes.
voice not see him float and make the magical stars just a
yes,
moment ago?
Fine.
How else would the voice explain all that? This voice was a part of himself, too. Surely,
oh, no.
surely, if he could just...
Am I a maniac?
He would prove it. He would prove that he was in control, that this was a dream. So he closed his eyes gently, and he invited himself to wake up. He felt the cool weight of the blanket on his skin. The press of the mattress on his back. The fresh air of a world outside this one.
I close my windows when I sleep.
Let me wake up, he thought to himself.
Yes.
I'm through with this dream. I wish it to be over.
Yeah.
Let me go back to my job. Let me continue pushing the buttons.
I like buttons.
Please. It's all I want. I want my apartment and my wife and my job. All I want is my life exactly the way it's always been.
I don't want that.
My life is normal. I am normal.
No, I'm not.
Everything will be fine.
I hope so.
I am okay.
Yes, I am. And then I open my eyes.
Stanley began screaming. Please, someone wake me up. My name is Stanley. I have a boss, I have
Stanley.
An office. I am real.
Get
please, just someone tell me I am real. I must be real.
No,
I must
red.
Be. Can anyone hear my voice? Who am I? Who am I?
And everything went black.
No.
This is the story of a woman named Mariella. Mariella woke up on a day like any other. She arose, got dressed, gathered her belongings, and walked to her place of work. But on this particular day, her walk was interrupted by the body of a man who had stumbled through town talking and screaming to himself, and then collapsed dead on the sidewalk.
Poor Stanley.
And although she would soon turn to go call for an ambulance, for just a few brief moments, she considered the strange man. He was obviously crazy. This much she knew. Everyone knows what crazy people look like. And in that moment, she thought to herself how lucky she was to be normal.
Yes.
I am sane. I am in control of my mind. I know what is real and what isn't.
Or do I?
It was comforting to think this, and in a certain way, seeing this man made her feel better. But then she remembered the meeting she had scheduled for that day. The very important people whose impressions of her would affect her career.
I gotta get going.
And by extension, the rest of her life. She had no time for this, so it was only a moment that she stood there, staring down at the body.
And then Stanley
and then she turned and ran.
Well, there's the Stanley parable. We'll see what crazy and wacky adventures we go on next time. Bye.